Home court advantage here inside the HTC Center. They're in their home whites. Tommy Burton, number 33, jumping it up against the 7-footer Brandon Carlson. Number three in the middle of that graphic in your starting five for the Chanticleers. 15 points a game, missed the first game of the season, but by the season's end, he'll be their top scorer. And the first two of the game. The crowd already into it. There's a young man they call Ibo Ibrahimadiba, the sophomore out of Sweden.
He's really their point forward, if you will. Because Jones is a scorer.
Here's Gotch. Smooth.
Yep, no question. Now, did he foul himself out? That's the question. If I'm Cliff Ellis, I give him to about the 10-9 minute mark, and I bring him back with two fouls. That's what this kid does.
He hangs and hits his first bucket of the game.
And they come back, honestly, very mature young people. And now it's just a matter of shaking that rust off of not playing basketball for 2 years.
Nice move by Timmy Allen.
Oh, yeah. He's a truck. He is unguardable. You can ask Pac-12 coaches. That's not hyperbole.
Here's Gums Frater off the curl. Gets it to go. First bucket for Terrell Gums Frater. And it'll pick off.
That's tough. If you got a guy like Carlson, throw the ball up in the air at the rim.
Garrett Green tries for three and nails it. That's what Cliff Ellis wants his team to do.
Well, we watched it yesterday. They want to spread this defense out. Attack, that doesn't happen much.
No, and he knocks it down.
Yeah.
0 for 2 this season coming in. He hits his first one of the year.
Helsinki, Finland, and that's the connection. Jantunen is a tough kid, number 20.
And Diva hits from deep. And beat him handily.
Pretty good right there. Yep.
Ibo. All the way from Salt Lake City. Step back three. No, the follow slam by LaGagna. Wow.
Or you're going to get in the body bag. Watch.
For the Chanticleers. Looking to build on a 6-point advantage. Jones hangs and hits. And the crowd is at full throw inside HTC Center.
At a St. Augs in New Orleans, one of the great. Don't really have a bucket getter right now other than Plummer, the junior college transfer.
Inside, Carlson. Nice touch for the 7-footer.
Really good move by Brandon Carlson.
Missions that some of these players have already gone on, they are older by age.
Three of them are, no doubt about it.
Bruton knocks it down. Ends up a 4-point play and a 23-12 Coastal Carolina lead. Plummer tries again, and this time he hits.
I like it, but he needs to stay on that 3-point line.
Goes to Timmy Allen. Allen just works his way to the basket and can't be stopped.
Monster. Clippers getting Paul George healthy finally.
Nice lead from Carlson.
Yes, sir.
And he shows the hops.
Yeah.
Now 6 minutes to go in the first half. Here's Carlson again showing the touch.
Really good touch. Didn't need to dribble it right there.
Utah's offense starting to get rolling now. They're 5 of their last 7 from the field. Jones make it 6 of their last 8. A 3-ball from the freshman Rylan Jones. Green got the call and the bucket. Ops on the bench for Larry Krystkowiak. He played under Rick Majerus back in the day.
And Rylan has been a really well-known player. Nice pass inside.
Timmy Allen in double digits now with 11. Spent a long time at Nevada. Helped put that program on the map. Then went over to the Georgia Bulldogs. Here's Green. Tough move by Garrett Green.
Defense locked in on Timmy Allen.
Plummer. That's aggressive big. From the outside.
That is really big, Rich. Eldon Campbell, Dale Davis, program builder wherever he's been.
Started at South Alabama. There's Green, another triple against the Pac-12's Utah Utes.
It's good defense. They really crowding the lane.
And the foul's gonna be called on Lagagna.
Jimmy said he's playing well. A season-long mission to find out, because you cannot, at least in theory.
Here's Green, left alone. Off the mark. The follow doesn't go. It's good if it goes, and it does! Keyshawn Bruton, with time running out in the first half, threw up a prayer from the baseline. Jones had a good first half. Gotch misses his first attempt for the second half. And here comes Adrima Diba, who's got 9 points in the first half, and he adds to that.
15 for 20 plus minutes, and they started the second half the same way.
Gotch aggressive, the foul by Carlson. One of the good things about these exempt tournaments and the non-conference portion of the college team schedule is you get to learn a lot.
Close quickly on both Gotch and Jones.
Allen wants it. Under the basket.
He ain't stopping him. He's a man in there.
Came up short. Here come the Utes. And Gotch. Jones, the teardrop, gets it to go.
Checking his hand, like, yeah. Soft touch. Very sloppy basketball right now by Utah.
Diva, how did he do that? I mean, he's 73 years old, and he's still looking down the road for this Coastal Carolina team. Jackson Frenchley gets in the scoring column and has an and one opportunity that gets circled on the calendar.
Oh, yeah. Yep. That's a great basketball state, the Beehive State.
Here's Bruton. Again, his third triple of the night.
Yep. Tell you what, they don't take bad shots either. They really don't.
Green gets the shooter's touch on that one. He's got a dozen.
They move it well. They get what they want.
Allen gets stuffed at the other end by Green. And Green's got a little something to say about it as well. Now Bruton. Yes! Boom.
Wow.
Gotch. Right place, right time. Yeah. Maybe that gets Booth Gotch going.
Gotch is the, you know, you got to have two Utes to score now, Rich. You're going to get back in this game.
Bruton again. You're kidding me!
Well, you can't leave them open.
From the Myrtle Beach Invitational.
And this is a team that's picked seventh in the Sun Belt, so.
Jones for three!
Play together on offense, they help. Look at that swarming, look at that swarming.
Ballstead had to force it up with shot clock running down. Here's Yamtunin again, and he has a chance at a three-point play. Good form. Cliff Ellis took the team to the Sweet 16. It was the 2003 Auburn Tigers. They lost by one in that tournament to the Syracuse Orange, who ended up winning the national championship that year.
Beautiful two-on-one. Had an ankle issue early in the season. Look at this, another run out.
Baseball pass. And Diva finishes it off. Good career high for Abrima Diva.
You know, this is how you practice. This is what we wanted to do. This is what it'll look like.
And finally, a shot drops.
Coastal Carolina has controlled the offensive end, taking good shots, moving the ball. And they don't seem to be a team that is going to beat themselves. Look at that floater. What was that?
On the shoulders of 5 three-pointers from him. And here he is again. Right on cue.
Saving some of those for tomorrow, man. You're gonna have to pay him a little bit.
Brenchley for three.
He can shoot it.
Field goal tonight.
Yeah, Batten and Gotch, two sophomores who are certainly a promising player. They did not bring their A game tonight.
There's Hippolyte for three. He joins the club. Another 7-footer for Larry Kostoriak's checked in. That's Matt Van Komen, who missed from close range. And there's Keyshawn Bruton with a rare two-pointer tonight.
And the defense was stellar, smothering, suffocating, and pretty good too.
It was another blowout win, but the surprise of the night turned in by the homestanding Chanticleers of Coastal Carolina. They upset the Utah Utes for their first ever win against the Pac-12 team. The final score is Coastal 79, Utah 57.